So this is the software PSIM. Its name is PSIM, Power Simulator.
सर आज इसका आइडिया कैसे आया?
मुझे उमेश ने भी पूछा था और भी बीच में इससे पहले किसी किसी ने पूछा था पावर सर्किट सिमुलेशन के लिए, तो दैट्स व्हाई आई थॉट कि व्हाई नॉट वील हैव अ सेशन ऑन दिस टू सिमुलेट द सर्किट।
ओके
तो सी इन दिस सॉफ्टवेयर ना डेमो वर्जन इज अवेलेबल फ्रीली ऑन ऑफिशियल, आई कैन से यू कैन डाउनलोड क्रैक वर्जन फ्रॉम द इंटरनेट, although it is not advisable to go for crack version, but you can download. So when you will open this software now, you will get the interface like this, where all these names has been written on the top: file, edit, view, sub circuit, simulate, option, utility, window, help, etc. So if you want to open a new file, just click either from the file you can go for new, or you have to directly shortcut has been given. You have to press Control plus N, so it will open a new file, or you can just click on this icon. So after clicking this icon, now see in this page, so many things has been already available in front of you, like some of the circuit elements. See here, I'm putting the cursor and it is showing the name. This is ground, this is resistor, this is inductor, capacitor, diode, thyristor, I mean to say SCR. This is MOSFET, IGBT. Similarly, this is a single phase diode bridge. Just by placing this box now, diode bridge will be automatically inside this box. Diode bridge has been made already. So similarly, so many different varieties we have in front of us. But suppose you are not getting any element from this place, you guys can go to the element. Okay, within the element we have like power, so many things. RLC branches are available, resistor, inductor, capacitor, RL, RC, so many things are available over here. Similarly, switches, diode, thyristor, NPN transistor, PNP transistor, MOSFET, varieties of semiconductor devices, all bridges, etc. are available. Similarly, you can choose transformer if it is required, magnetic elements, this is op-amp if you need, motor drive. So all these are within power. Similarly, control block is here. You can go for filters, you can go for computational block like multiplier, divide, square root, sine inverse, cosine, all these things, whatever mathematically you want to calculate, all the facility has been given. Similarly, logic elements, I'm showing those elements which you guys are familiar with, like AND, OR, JOR, JK flip flop, analog to digital converter, digital to analog converter. So all these blocks are available. Whatever you want to simulate, you can choose accordingly. Sources are here. Different symbols are also given. So basically what we are going to do with the help of this software, with the help of this software, we are going to perform simulation. What is the meaning of simulation? Simulation means whatever circuit idea you have, without expending a single rupee, you are manufacturing that. Okay, manufacturing in the terms of what? We are manufacturing in the terms of mathematical equation, and then after we are trying to get whether whatever result you want to get, that is achievable with that circuit or not. Okay, so what I will do, I will take three or four examples of simple circuits so that you guys will familiar with how we can do simulation in this. So I would like to start with a very simple circuit. Like I will take AC input, and then after I will connect a resistor, and this simulation will perform. We'll see different waveforms. We'll try to see different measurements and so on. Okay. In between, at any step, if you are not getting, just stop me. You can ask questions. So see, from this place, I'm choosing the sinusoidal voltage. See, the moment I'm placing the cursor, just see at this place within this box, name will appear. So I'm putting cursor over here. Like the sinusoidal voltage source. So I'm taking one sinusoidal voltage source from this place. Okay. From here itself. Ab dekho. Isme na, there is one facility, one good facility. The moment you will select an element now, at the place of cursor, this element will be shown. If you want to rotate this element before placing, just click right click of the mouse. You know? The moment you'll do right click now, it will take 90 degree rotation. Like I'm clicking on the right hand side of the mouse, and it is rotating by 90 degree. So suppose there is a requirement to rotate the elements. So with the help of right click, you guys can do it. Now I will choose resistor. So I'm placing resistor over here. Now here is the wire element. Just click on this. Now cursor will become this symbol, and it is basically the wire. What you have to do? Keep this the tip of this wiring pin at a particular place. Click on left side of the mouse button and then drag. Okay. So it will join two things. Now I am taking one ground symbol from this place. Again, I am taking this wiring thing and I'm connecting these two points. I've connected a very simple circuit I have made. Now what I'm going to do, I want to change the value of this AC source and also the value of resistance. So before doing anything to select the elements, it is better to take the select cursor. So I am selecting the select cursor, and then after I will click on this this AC source. Now see, it is showing so many parameters. Like what is the name of this source, V1. Suppose I want to keep the name VAC. So it will be, and if I will mark a tick on this now, it will be displayed on with this symbol. So see here, VAC now available with this AC source. What is this? So the second parameter, peak amplitude. Suppose I want to simulate this circuit by keeping in mind the single phase supply available to us. We know that whatever single phase supply is available to us, its peak amplitude equal to how much is the peak amplitude? Whatever AC is available with us,
325.
Okay, good. So at the place of 110, I will change this value to 325. What is the frequency? 60 hertz already given, but in India we have 50 hertz, so I will keep the value 50 hertz. Phase angle, I want to start this AC from zero. There is no phase difference. I do not want to put any phase difference. DC offset, no, I do not want to put any DC offset. Also, I do not want to delay this waveform. So all these values, all these parameters, three parameters will be zero. Okay, so this is the input. Now I will click on the resistor. I can give similarly resistor name, like I will say this is the load. So this is RL I'm writing, and I can display it. Value at the place of 12 ohm, I'm taking 10 ohm. Okay, if you want to display the value also, just mark a tick over here and the value will be displayed. Similarly here also I can mark these two values, and these two values will be displayed. 325 volt, 50 hertz, all the parameters will be available. Okay, now I have to do measurement. So for the measurement, some of the blocks are in front of us. Like this is the voltage probe. Okay, suppose I'm placing this voltage probe at this place. So what this voltage probe will measure it is going to measure the voltage of this node with respect to this ground. This point you have to understand. This voltage probe will always measure the voltage of the node, the place where it has been placed, with respect to common point, with respect to ground. Okay. So one voltage I am measuring over here, so it will give AC input. There is another voltage measurement. Suppose at any place you want to measure the voltage between two nodes, so you have to use this method or this voltage measurement way. So I will connect. See, here is the dot. See, at this place there is a dot now. This dot reflects that this is the point where voltage will be measured, and this will be measured with respect to what? This is going to be measured with respect to this point. Okay. So now suppose I want to measure the current. So I must have to put a meter in between. So just to put ammeter, what we are going to do, we'll select ammeter from this place, current probe it is also known as. And now after deleting this wire, I will connect this current probe in between. So now I have connected ammeter. Okay, now let me write the name of this voltage measurement and current measurement so that I can recognize the waveform by its name. This is the I1 and this is the VP1. So all name has been displayed on this circuit. Let me enlarge a little bit. So I'm enlarging this one. Okay, so this is the circuit which I have created. Now, after creating the circuit, the next step is you have to do simulation, run simulation. So the moment I will click run simulation, now see what will happen. A separate sim view, at this place you guys can see the name of this is sim view. That means simulated waveforms will be shown within this window. Okay. And which waveform will be shown? The waveform which I'm going to select. Like suppose V1, I'm going to select, and we know that where is the V1? V1 is what? The measurement of this supply. Okay. So I'm going to click over here. Agar aap se miss ho jaye, suppose you have shut down those windows, not an issue at all, you can simulate it one more time. So again those windows will appear. Okay, so this V1 I'm adding over here and I'm clicking OK. Now see, no perfect sinusoidal has not been shown. Why it is? Because simulation time is very less. You have started simulation from 0 to only 0.01. 0.01 means what? It is 10 milliseconds. And we know that since I have written frequency equal to 50 hertz, it means it is going to be 20 millisecond time period, at least one cycle. If I want to say the simulation time should be equal to 20 millisecond. Are you getting my point, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'm going to do next, I'm going to change the simulation time. So how the simulation time will be changed? There is within this sub block, there is a control which I have named simulation control. So I will place this simulation control near to the circuit. The moment I will place it, a window will appear where I can change the total simulation time. This is the time step. Okay. What is the meaning of time step? That means it is calculating. It is, what is this circuit? Actually, this software, whatever I'm making whatever circuit I'm designing on this platform now, actually behind this code will be generated. And code will be based on what? All these voltage and current mathematical equations. Okay, so the value of equations will be calculated, the value of measuring parameters will be calculated after each step. And what is the time step? Like at zero, first value will be calculated, then 1 into e to the power minus 5. It means 1 into 10 to the power minus 5. The second point where the next value will be calculated. Then third value will be calculated at 2 into 10 to the power minus 5 and so on. So within whole simulation time, there will be 1000 points which we are calculating, and with the help of those values which we are getting from the steps, our waveform will be plotted. Okay, so I'm going to change this total time duration, and suppose I want to get 2 cycles, so I'm keeping it 40 milliseconds so that 2 cycles will appear within the waveform. Okay, so you just have to change this total time at this point of time, and it is more than sufficient. So I'm again simulating. Now see, 2 cycle is available. Okay, so suppose I want to plot one more waveform on the same scale, you have to click on this place. You click on this place, another I can add another graph in this. So this is another graph. This V1 and VP1, both are same. You know, because within the circuit diagram, you can see that these two things are connected in parallel. This AC source and this resistive load connected in parallel. So voltage at AC source and voltage across the load, both will be exactly same. And that's why these two graphs are overlapping. Why it is two graphs? You can see over here. One graph is in red, another graph is in blue. Okay. And both are having exactly same value, and that's why it is overlapping to each other. Now I will plot on the same axis, I'm plotting the current. Okay. Now this current, since its amount is very small, and that's why it is having the smaller value. And here you can see, this is the third graph. Suppose you want to remove two graphs from this, you can easily remove from here. Select, suppose voltage across resistor and current through the, what is this VP1? Go to the circuit diagram. VP1 is what? It is the value of voltage across resistor. What is the I1? I1 is the current which is passing through this resistor. Okay, these two are the values. So suppose these two quantity I want to remove. So simply I will click on remove. So these two quantity will be removed, and I will click on OK. And so I will get only one waveform over here. Okay. Suppose I want to plot the other waveforms in different window. So you have to click over here, and a separate, within the separate window, next waveform, whatever waveform you are selecting, that will be plotted in the separate window. Similarly, like this current will be plotted in again separate window. So all three graphs, you can check the graphs. This is the V1, voltage across the source. This is the voltage across the load. And this is the current coming from the source or going to the load. So all are having this kind of nature. Suppose I want to see the value of it at any point of time. So I will from this place now, so value of XY at the selected curve. I will choose this one, and I will click at any place, or I can move this one from here to here, and it will show the different value. You can see the value over here. Just check the value at this place. Okay. So I am just changing this one, and this value is changing. Like if I'm keeping over here at this time. What is the time this time? 4.74 × 10⁻³. Okay. Mm-hmm. At this point of time, let me make it 5. Although it is quite difficult to make it 5. Oh, okay. 5.5 × 10⁻³, nearly 5 milliseconds. What is the value of V1? 3.24 × 10⁻². That means it is going to be multiplied with 100. So this value will be equal to 324.94. VP1 324.94. How much is the current? This is going to be multiplied with 10⁻¹. If these two are multiplied with 10⁻², whereas this one has been multiplied with 10⁻¹. So this value will be 32.49. That means the current which is flowing through the resistor at this point of time is 32.4 ampere. So I hope the basic fundamental how to see the graph, how we can plot the graph, how we can take the value from it, all these are clear to all of you. Do you have any question related to this? Any question you would like to ask, guys?
Sir, ye separate kaise hai? Pehle to combined thi na?
Ha, just by clicking over here, see. This plot, we have two window by which we can do the plot.
Okay, sir.
One plot is good.